Yo, this is Clayton Thomas-Muller with 350.org. I'm here at the Solutions 21, which is the corporate greenwashing space here at the COP21 in Paris, France. I'm with Kandi Mossett of the Indigenous Rising Delegation, which is part of the North American Grassroots Global Justice It Takes Roots Delegation that has come here to expose some of the false solutions that are being profiled by companies like Suez, which is a France-based fracking corporation that was just called out as part of the France Climate Justice Coalition's toxic tour here on day one of Climate Solutions 21. And so I wanted to ask Kandi, what do you think about the corporate greenwashing that's taking place here, and why did you participate in today's action?
First of all, just being in this space is quite scary. The things that they're proposing as solutions are definitely not going in the right direction of what we need. I decided to be here today for this because I wanted to speak about the dangers of fracking, having experienced it firsthand in my own community. There is currently a ban here in Paris on fracking, but there are fracking water companies here, and this Suez company is all around it and trying to infiltrate, trying to get in. And so basically I wanted to just talk about some of the things that are happening in my community and share that emotion with others, how it destroys lives and it is a false solution, and it shouldn't be, you know, people shouldn't buy into it because it's some fancy building that the corporations can afford to rent.
So you come from the Fort Berthold, three affiliated tribes in North Dakota, United States, you know, the Bakken formation. Can you talk a little bit about what's going on in the Bakken?
Yes, I can. So there's shale oil trapped underneath 10,000 feet down. They came into our communities, told our people, here's some money, let us dig. It's going to be fine. There'll be no environmental impacts. Well, they lied. Our tribal government sold us out, signed contracts with corporations and companies after the 2005 Energy Act, which allowed them to have the Halliburton loophole. That allowed companies to not have to tell us any of the poisons and chemicals and toxins that they're putting in our water. And now they're polluting us and killing us, sterilizing the land, poisoning the air and water, and we are the ones that are dealing with the impacts, both environmental and social.
So last question, just real quick. I wanted to know, you know, a lot of people continue to try and say that natural gas and frack gas is a bridge or a transition fuel to a greener world. What are your final thoughts on this greenwashing frame?
The truth about fracking is that in North Dakota and in other places where they're doing it, the natural gas is actually a byproduct. There isn't pipeline infrastructure, and so they're flaring literally enough energy to heat half a million homes every single day. Just in North Dakota alone, is going up in fire, in smoke. It looks like a war zone there, going after the oil, which we have an excess of. Oil's floating around on barges. It's being stored in Oklahoma. And so it's backwards. It's completely backwards. And natural gas is not a clean bridge. Renewables, the gift that we get from the sun that we have right now, the wind that blows, those are the kinds of things we need to be subsidizing.
Awesome. Well, listen, we're going to be continuing as the IEN media team to cover actions here all throughout COP. You know, follow us on Twitter and Instagram with the hashtag Indigenous Rising, hashtag Defend, Protect, Renew, hashtag It Takes Roots. We'll see you out in the streets here in Paris.